If you're still posting static social media quotes and not getting the engagement you're looking for, then stick around because I'm going to show you how to boost your social media game with clean design and silky smooth animations all within Canva. All right, before we get started, make sure you have a Canva account. If you don't have one, you can create a free one now. Just click on the link in the description down below. Now come to Create a Design and click on Custom Size and type in 1920 by 1080 and smash that key. Now to get started, I want to add a space to the left to hold all the important information like company logo, speaker headshot, name and title, and of course the question copy. So to create this space, I'll come to my toolbar and click on Elements. From there, I'm going to add an organic shape, so I'll search for Blob. I'll then pick one that works well for the space and that's not so distracting. With that selected, I'll then adjust the size by grabbing any of the four handles. Next, I'll adjust the color by coming to the color box and then I'll add a custom hex code. With that in place, I'm going to add the organization logo by coming to the toolbar and selecting uploads. From there, click on upload media and locate the file on your device. Now I'll just select that from my image library and adjust the size. And that looks about right. So now I want to add in the question copy to support the audio clip. For that, I'm going to come to my text tool and adjust the heading. Then I'll double click the font and change it to Deja Vu Sans. Then I'll adjust the placement. Now I want the viewer to see who's talking, so there's some sort of human connection. To do that, I'll first come to Elements and search for Blob. But instead of a static image, I want my blob to move behind the speaker's headshot. This will cause the viewer to look in that direction. So now I'll go to my filters icon and click on Animated. Next up is adding the speaker's headshot. To do that, I first need the frame. So I'll go to the search bar and type in frame. I'll then choose an organic frame and then upload the speaker's headshot just like we did previously. Then just drag and drop it into the frame. I'll then double click the image and adjust the size. I'll then add in the speaker's name and title. And for the final part of this design, I'll add in the supporting image. And with the design completed, I'm going to add in some animations. To do that, you could just click on Animations and choose a preset that would apply to the whole design. But because we want this to pop, I'm going to add animations to the elements individually. To get started, I'm going to start selecting elements and playing around with different presets to get the look I'm going for. In this case, I really just want the elements to the left to slide in while having the supporting image zoom out. Doing this will give the overall design some depth and interest. This looks good enough to post, but before we do, I still need to add in my audio clip. To apply audio in your Canva project, just go to Uploads and then Upload Media and select the audio file on your device. Then simply drag the audio file onto your design. It should start autoplaying and I'm about 99% sure it's going to cut off your audio in the wrong spot. So to fix that, just change the overall animation time of your design to the length of your audio clip. In this case, the audio clip is 24 seconds long, so I'll come to the top and select Edit Timing, and I'll change that to 24 seconds. Now when I hit play, it should start playing my audio clip perfectly. Lastly, I'll export the finished design by coming to Download and selecting MP4 video. Once Canva is done preparing your final video, you're good to start sharing this with your audience. I really do love creating these video quotes because it allows you to squeeze more out of your new and old audio content. So what are you waiting for? Start getting more out of your content today.